These are our current aluminium tubes, and we are going to check to figure out if aluminium tubes or carbon tubes are better. Also, we want to learn a lot about carbon winding and explore the factory of CompoTech. Luca and Mars are already waiting in the car, so it's time for me to catch up and let's go!
Good morning, we're in Czech.
So we obviously arrived at CompoTech. Now we're going inside and we compare our current aluminium tubes with carbon tubes and see what's better.
Here we go.
All right, with Kavenz we are fairly known for aluminium frames, but with the new project we wanted to explore a new field of material, and that's why we are today with Andre. And we wanted to start actually maybe with a little introduction of yourself.
I'm Andre and I'm a designer at CompoTech, and we do carbon fiber tubes and profiles for a whole range of industries.
So they can do this and they can do that.
All right, I think he missed all one really important stuff. He's a mountain biker. There are a lot of mountain bikers in the company, so it's really relatable. The people really know what they're talking about. They operate in a lot of different industries, but biking is where the passion is, I would say.
Yes.
So that's really good. That's where we have a really good connection point. And yeah, we want to learn about the winding, the tube winding, because we met you guys on the craft bike days. And we got keen. And we wanted to explore this option for frames. We have a first sample. This is the aluminium top tube. This is the carbon top tube. And maybe you can walk us through the process, how this tube would be made.
So all our tubes are made by filament winding. And all these winding starts with the internal tool. So we have a mandrel, which is inside of a tube. And our unique point of this technology is that we have a pins all around on both ends, and we can place like a single strand of fiber and hook it on these pins.
So it's endless carbon fiber.
Yes, it's endless.
Right. It has exactly. Two ends and no more.
Exactly. Yeah. And thanks to these pins, we can also place the fibers in a 0 degree angle, and thus we can create tubes which has superior bending stiffness and bending strength as well.
Yeah, which is super important for like the lateral load cases like pedaling. And
yes, exactly. But not confused, we can also do all other angles, like from basically 0 to 90 degrees. And we can, as we are winding with a single fiber, we can really optimize in each layer to have the fiber at angle different, so we can really tune the properties of the tube to your bike.
Okay, so after the tube is winded, what is the next step in the process?
Well, next step is to overwind it with a tape. That's why it has like little lines on it.
Uh-huh,
okay. You can see them, hopefully on a light. And then it is hardened. At first, we harden it at a room temperature. And then we harden it at in the oven, sorry.
So the hardening is also known as curing, right?
Yes, as a curing, yes. And in an oven, it gives much better mechanical properties than just the room temperature.
Yeah, and I saw the process before, so I found it really interesting that that you run the carbon fibers through a bath of the resin.
You are using a wet winding process. That means we are taking a dry fiber, then we impregnate it in a resin bath, and then this wet fiber is wound.
Okay, cool. So you don't have to add resin after all, no infusion, nothing. You just wrap the tape around it to make it as compact,
to squeeze out the resin, which is not necessary. And it sounds fairly simple, but we can make pretty good volume fraction, let's say up to 62%.
That's pretty good, yeah. Impressive. Now let's go outside and do some testing. We do the comparing of the stiffness, and we do some destructive testing. Gonna be the most interesting part of the video, I guess.
So what we want to do now, we want to compare the stiffness of the down tube and the impact resistance.
What? Basically,
as you can see, the setup that we choose is pretty simplified and not ideal and not scientific, but you can see the results pretty clearly. The carbon tube bends a lot less.
Now, after we tested the bending, we can go outside and do the destructive testing.
Let's go!
Do the impact test. Yeah, I know everybody's worried. Everybody likes aluminium for the good behavior in case of an impact. It doesn't burst, it just bends or dents. So we will just test it, how much the aluminium versus the carbon can take. Yeah, basically what we are doing here is some super ghetto testing. It just works for YouTube. It's not scientific at all, but it's fun and it's definitely fun to watch and it illustrates the behavior. If we wanted to do that scientifically, we would need a lot of more samples and a lot of a better setup than me just drawing from a given height. Try to be as repetitive as can, but yeah, don't do this at home and don't take this for science. Okay. Oh, and there comes safety glasses because yeah, we don't want to get blind. Gotta drive 800 kilometers back home. All right, let's see what happens. Impact test. Let's start from here. Is that about the same height? Okay, 1, 2, 3. Ooh! Ugly! So, I mean, this is also not rideable anymore, that's for sure. Let's see what carbon does.
It was 58 centimeters apart.
So I hope we don't just break both of them. Should have started a little more gentle. Who's ready for carbon? This is gonna burst. Be careful with your eyes. Hold your breath. Ready in. 1, 2, 3. Whew. Okay. Both break badly. We started too fast, I think. 10 kilo out of that height is a lot. I can do something a little bit random. I can turn it around and put my own weight on it and see how they behave now. So kind of gives a good idea of how rideable they would still be. So you hear it. There's still a lot of fibers holding. But it doesn't completely burst. The same as this one. I mean, this is completely crooked, right? So you can see like well different behavior. This would ride like this now and the carbon frame would still go straight. So that would be the good part about it. I think this would hold my weight easily. So both tubes are still rideable. So I mean, yeah, to be honest, we never had any frame with a dent like this ever come back to us. So it's a completely unrealistic scenario. It's just fun to do. And yeah, this would have been completely misaligned. This was actually holding the shape pretty long, so it's super interesting. And we should have definitely started with a little bit less weight to have this more realistic. Like you wouldn't have any real world scenario where this is fixated and this is fixated and you impact something. This is impossible, it would never happen like this. So what we basically trying to simulate here is this scenario. How much this can happen, and maybe we can still use the old tubes to simulate that. Yeah. So it's about my belly button, right? Ready, steady. So it literally just got some scratches. Is that about the same setup? So this is a more realistic scenario, and we can see here we have a dent. And here we have a scratch in the paint. So this is basically what we wanted to show in the video. We just started a little bit too fast. So this is, we see frames like this. We get frames like this back, we see them in the field. This happens to aluminium for sure. Like, and that's how the carbon reacts on it. Doesn't look very impressed. We can maybe try one heavier stone and then be done here. Okay. 1, 2, 3. Oh yeah, that's a big dent. Yeah, that looks bad. That's what a rock can do for you. Now let's do the same thing with the carbon tube. Stone versus carbon tube. 1, 2, 3. The carbon tube has an impact. So this would be a scenario where we wouldn't recommend riding anymore, but it still feels like very, very safe. Good, good, that was fun. Now we come to the main point why we are here. We wanted to confirm the tolerances
of the tubes and see how precise they can be. And we figured the tolerances are within 1/10 of what we wanted. So we don't really have to adjust the drawings of our tubes. We just have to adjust the tolerances of the lugs to get the perfect bonding gap and can start CNC production. Let's go!